He's nothing like any other Indonesian politician. A heavy metal music lover, an outsider to the political elite.
Kalau kita tidak mau berubah, kita akan ditinggal oleh perubahan.
The governor of Indonesia's capital, Jakarta, has won a legion of fans through subsidized education, free healthcare, and fighting corruption.
Memang Jokowi luar biasa. Dan harapan rakyat bahwa Jokowi lah menjadi presiden yang paling hebat.
Joko Widodo, known as Jokowi, could soon be running a country of 240 million.
Assalamualaikum.
Polls show he's far ahead of his rivals in the race for July's presidential elections.
We as the elite only have to follow what people likes. Yeah, and this is what I can see. When people like to have Jokowi, you cannot stop that anymore.
Siapa yang dukung Jokowi, tepuk tangan.
But critics say this one small town furniture seller is untested as a national leader and out of his league.
He doesn't know what to do with Indonesia.
There's no concept.
No concept.
I'm Steph Farson. On this edition of 101 East, we go behind the scenes with Indonesian presidential candidate Joko Widodo and ask, does he have what it takes to lead the nation?
Besok pagi-pagi aja ketemu ya.
Oh, saya punya ada perlu saya pengen saya sampaikan.
Ya.
Ya.
Jokowi has a big job. As the governor of Jakarta, he oversees Southeast Asia's most congested city, one beset by corruption, poverty, and pollution.
Selalu banjir tiap hujan asap jalan dari awan di jantung metropolitan.
We've been given exclusive access to follow Jokowi over the next 2 weeks. A challenging task with a man who changes his schedule constantly and only decides at the last minute where he will go. He's made it his personal mission to tackle the city's problems. He's on the road every day, making surprise visits to check if work's been done. A leadership style not seen before in Indonesia.
Kalau kita datang ke sebuah tempat, kemudian disiapkan, yang kita lihat hanya yang baik-baik. Yang jelek nggak akan kelihatan. Yang tidak baik nggak akan kelihatan. Karena sudah disiapkan.
Hey, aku ada di dalam kota metropolitan.
Salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
One of Jokowi's biggest challenges is Jakarta's yearly floods, which paralyze the city. To dredge the rivers and build new reservoirs, he has to move more than 1 million illegal squatters.
Tapi Jakarta banjir cukup besar kan? Ini cukup untuk mengatasi?
Ya, kita kan banyak. Tahun ini ada 9 waduk baru. Yang sudah dimulai baru berapa? 1, 2, 2. Ini sama di mana? Pondok Rangon.
For the first time, people in Jakarta can easily approach their leader and bombard him with questions.
Kami sebagai masyarakat, Pak, merasa terganggu masalah pembangunan ini, Pak.
Karena apa?
Alasannya apa? Karena kita tidak tahu batas-batas mana yang kami untuk waduk ini.
Nah, sudah saya itu, Pak, yang enggak, dari atas nanti sudah saya pesan, nanti bicara di situ. Ya, setiap persoalan itu harus dengan masyarakat harus terbuka supaya mereka percaya bahwa enggak ada yang kita tutup-tutupi.
One whose life has dramatically changed because of Jokowi is Sulastri.
Iya banyak sih perubahannya, mendingan ini, mendingan sekarang kehidupannya warga-warga ini. Soalnya selama ini kan bertahun-tahun hidupnya kumuh ya di situ, sampai sekarang udah mendingan, udah jadi taman, banyak anak-anak kalau sore makan di situ, pada disuapin, penghijauan bagus lah.
Sulastri, her husband and baby girl, moved into this low-cost apartment 6 months ago.
Enaknya di sini tuh nggak ada tikus, ya bersih, binatang-binatang kayak nyamuk juga nggak ada, labang apa nggak. Kalau di sono kan banyak tikusnya, banyak apanya, ya. Sampahnya juga di sini kan nggak ada, bersarang bersih.
Jadi Anda tinggal di mana sebelumnya?
Tadinya pas belum di sono, belum di situ, saya di sini, dekat jalan raya. Cuman di situ lebih parah, banjir terus.
We go down to the slum area where Sulastri used to live.
Ini rumah mertua nih. Dulu waktu udah gusuran saya tinggalnya di sini.
Halo, apa kabar?
Baik.
Ibu tinggal di mana?
Muara Baru.
Di sini?
Iya.
Kok belum pindah?
Masih betah di sini. Ya emang dari sini saya udah lama, udah tahunan.
Many have lived here all their lives, crammed together in these shacks and these illegal settlements. The governor was widely hailed when he started to demolish the slum areas, but not everyone agreed.
Kan penduduk udah segini banyaknya, mau taruh di mana lagi? Nggak bisa lah, nggak bisa semaunya. Kan di sini kan bukannya ratusan orang, ribuan.
Sulastri tells me that many slum dwellers were forced to leave Jakarta because there was no room for them in the new apartments. We've also got reports from residents that government officials are secretly selling apartments that are supposed to be free. We put these claims to Jokowi. Corruption is still a big problem in Indonesia, and you as the governor had already a few cases yourself of people who have been involved in corruption working under you. And this is a letter I got from a resident of a low-cost housing apartment, and those apartments are supposed to be free, but he claims in this letter that they're now being sold.
Rusun di Waduk Fluid, Muara Baru sudah banyak diperjualbelikan oleh orang-orang yang tidak bertanggung jawab. Lantai 1 harga 60 juta, lantai 2 40 juta, lantai 3 35 juta per kamar.
The governor says he will investigate the allegations and insists he has no tolerance for any corruption.
Ya, membangun sistem baru, kemudian men-training birokrasi, men-training masyarakat, dan juga kontrol yang lebih.
Dan Bapak yakin mereka akan dengar?
Tidaknya sekali, diperingatkan, diganti, peringatkan, dicopot, ingatkan lagi, ganti, ingatkan lagi, copot, cek lagi, cek lagi, cek lagi. Memang harus seperti itu.
But Jakarta's governor is facing an uphill battle. Indonesia is one of the world's most corrupt countries, according to Transparency International. Today, Jokowi is taking the fight straight to the city's bureaucrats.
Gara-gara kalau ngomong dengan saya, seperti itu pasti saya ngerti. Ini benar, ini nggak betul, Pak Zai. Setiap perintah pasti saya ikuti. Jangan diberi hal yang basa-basi. Gimana kemarin jamnya dari tanah belum? Udah Pak, gimana? Di Monas Pak berapa? 400 Pak saya ya. Hanya 3.
Jokowi shows the officials photos depicting some of the city's problems.
Malu kita kalau ada orang asing, sih malu. Pertanyaan saya, jawaban saya apa coba? Kalau saudara-saudara jadi gubernur, ditanya ini apa, menjelaskannya gimana? Saudara-saudara boleh tertawa, tapi saya sedih kalau sudah ditanya seperti itu. Sedih. Ini ibu kota negara.
Pemimpin-pemimpin lain di Indonesia.
Journalist Yon Tyrone had full access to Jokowi to write his biography. He says the challenges facing the governor are clear.
Banyak pejabat-pejabat di bawah dia yang tidak bisa mendukung pekerjaan dia, yang tidak bisa mendukung dia melakukan perubahan. Perilaku asal bapak senang itu masih ada sampai sekarang. Jadi dia, Jokowi itu cuma punya 2 tangan, 10 jari, dan tidak mungkin dia bisa mengurus semuanya tanpa mendengar laporan dari bawahan-bawahan dia. Tapi kan tidak mungkin setiap hari, setiap waktu dia harus belusukan, memastikan itu semua.
But Jokowi is determined to be hands-on.
Nggak ada yang tahu kita ke sini.
The next day, he's visiting a school on the city's outskirts. His popularity has soared since he introduced an education card for the poor. With the card, poor families can buy school uniforms and books for their children.
Gak mungkin dia ke sekolah tanpa pakai seragam. Gak mungkin dia ke sekolah tanpa sepatu. Dia akan malu, kan? Itu yang kadang-kadang kalau kita nggak sering ke lapangan nggak tahu. Oh, sekolah sudah gratis, sekolah sudah gratis. Nggak pernah ke lapangan nggak tahu. Problemnya tidak itu.
Dipakai untuk apa?
Buku.
Beli buku, terus?
Tas.
Tas. Tasnya mana? Bukunya mana? Terus?
Sepatu.
Sepatunya itu?
Ya.
Itu dari KJP? Benar?
Ya.
Harganya berapa itu?
Masuk 120.
Iya?
Iya.
Benar?
Benar.
Sepatunya Pak Agup aja hanya 60 ribu.
Jokowi is satisfied. The education card is money well spent.
Kenapa Bapak sangat peduli sama orang miskin?
Perjalanan hidup saya, sejarah saya mungkin mempengaruhi. Saya dulu hidup di slum area, di pinggir sungai, 4 kali digusur.
Everywhere he goes, Jokowi hands out notebooks to school children.
Biar bagi sana aja, tapi jangan nutupi tadi, yang penting jangan nutupi.
You can see that people are massively supporting you and you've brought some kind of hope to them. Are you not worried that these expectations are so high you could never fulfill them?
Ya enggak apa-apa. Hidup itu harus, hidup akan bergairah kalau punya harapan. Rakyat juga akan lebih bergairah, gairah bekerja, gairah memperbaiki kotanya, gairah membangun negaranya kalau punya harapan.
Bapak nggak takut nanti harapan itu terlalu besar, nggak bisa dipenuhi?
Harus dipelihara dan harus dipenuhi sekuat dan sebisa kita.
And this power could soon grow. Jokowi has only been Jakarta's governor for just 18 months. A media pack follows his every move. Speculation is growing. He will run for president for the Indonesian Democratic Party of Struggle.
Jadi gimana Pak? Diminta buat jadi capres? Diminta buat maju dalam bursa pemilihan presiden?
Begini. Mulai keringetan.
After months of keeping the nation guessing, it soon becomes clear something big is about to happen. We travel with the governor to North Jakarta, where he finally announces the news.
Saya telah mendapatkan mandat menjadi calon presiden Republik Indonesia dari PDI Perjuangan. Dan dengan mengucap bismillahirrahmanirrahim, saya siap melaksanakan.
Telepon ya Pak ya, mandatnya Pak. Izin Pak, mandatnya telepon Pak.
Yeah, I think Mr. Jokowi is number one that he is win because lots of the Indonesian people already waiting for him coming. He never says I'm come president, but many lots of the Indonesians are coming, hope he's coming for president.
Jokowi is like Obama because when people like to have a change. After 10 years of democracy, corruptions and all the things that fed them up that they don't see anymore leader, then they see this as a common people like them and like to have him. And we have to accommodate that. We have to see that this is the voice of the people.
The campaign is now in full swing, but his opponents say Jokowi is untested on the national stage and lacks experience. Fadlizon from a rival party says the Jakarta governor is not ready to run the country.
We are gambling. Indonesia is very huge, big, and in some area also very tough, yeah, like Aceh and Papua. I would like to see it like this, you know. If you see a fish in an aquarium, which is very nice to see, you know, beautiful, And if we put the fish in the river or in the sea, maybe that's a different case, you know.
You don't see the fish anymore.
I don't know whether it will survive or not.
Find out more about the man who could be Indonesia's next president, we travel to Solo, his hometown in central Java. He grew up on the riverbanks here, in a family of carpenters and furniture sellers.
Selamat siang.
Ya, halo, Pak. Selamat siang, Mbak. Halo. Mari, Mbak, silakan
bisa
masuk.
Bisa bicara sebentar?
Iya, bisa.
Apa kabar? Mbak.
Mari, baik.
Jadi Bapak kenal Pak Jokowi ya?
Iya, untuk kecil.
Suharno was Jokowi's old neighbor and watched him grow up.
Nah, itu terhitung orang biasa aja kok. Bapaknya kerjanya keras, ibunya kerjanya keras, dia sendiri juga itu. Biarpun masih anak, jiwanya sudah jiwa dewasa gitu loh Mbak. Kan kelihatan, nggak mau main-main sama kawan-kawan gitu, tapi sukanya menyendiri, mancing, kalau mancing tuh bawa buku Bung Karno itu dibaca gitu loh.
Suharno remembers clearly when the neighborhood was evicted under the iron rule of former President Suharto in the 1970s. It's an event that deeply affected Jokowi and the community.
Ya, tahu-tahu terus didatangi dari itu pemerintahan waktu itu masih orde lama Pak Soeharto itu, orde baru Pak Soeharto itu harus pergi bapaknya mau dibikin itu terminal tergandeng itu.
When he grew up, Jokowi joined a family business, a furniture factory. Disappointed in how his city was being governed, he entered politics, and in 2005 he was elected mayor of Solo. To transform the poor city into an economic hub.
Masalahnya Pak Jokowi itu nggak kepengen kaya atau nggak apa, yang penting rakyat itu bisa hidup, ekonomi, bidang kesehatan, bidang pendidikan, ini cerita nyata masalahnya, jiwanya kan begitu.
A few days after her son's nomination, we meet Jokowi's mother, Ibu Noto.
Nggak pernah lihat dia, oh ini anaknya bisa jadi presiden.
Ya enggak, saya enggak ngira itu, enggak ngira. Enggak ada bayangan itu, belum, enggak ada sama sekali. Gubernur, wali kota, apalagi presiden itu, enggak. Kalau kerja jujur, ya kerja apa aja, terus selalu harus jujur. Ikhlas, tulus, jadi apa saja, kerja apa saja itu harus dipegang. Saya dari dulu masih kecil sudah saya tanamkan.
Mungkin sebelum, mungkin menurut saya ini adalah keberhasilan utama Jokowi adalah membuat saya dan mungkin warga Solo itu merasa bangga bahwa saya adalah warga Solo gitu.
Stefanus Aci shares a passion with Jokowi, one that has made them firm friends. A passion for heavy metal music.
Emang sangat suka Metallica, suka dia ya, hampir semua musik rock di era itulah. Semua orang Indonesia kayaknya suka musik rock. Cuman beberapa orang kemudian setelah merasa tua, kemudian tidak mengakui pernah saya sudah sehat sembuh gitu. Tapi Jokowi masih menganggap bahwa saya adalah metalhead gitu. Itu luar biasa.
Nggak terganggu juga di kamar, udah kamarnya sendiri udah jerang-jering, saya biarin. Cok adik-adiknya itu, tuh Mas Joko, berising Bu, itu berising. Ya biarin.
Nanti ikut nyanyi waktu dengar musik?
Ya lunjak-lunjak itu, sampai sekarang masih senang.
Udah 50 lebih?
52 tahun.
Masih ABG sedikit.
Iya.
Enggak ya? Ya, enggak tahu, tapi ada hubungan lah antara
Meta dan Jokowi. Yang terakhir saya hadir sudah jam berapa? Jam 11 malam. Iya, ya betul ya, malam ya kita datang sudah malam. Dan orang nggak tahu saya udah nonton di situ udah lama, ada gini-gini, ya gini udah baru. Wah, Jokowi bubar aja.
Baik langsung.
Jokowi's passion for heavy metal is not the only thing that distinguishes him from other Indonesian politicians. He's not from a military background nor part of the elite. If elected president, he will face challenges unlike anything he has encountered before in a country battling a slowing economy, plagued by natural disasters, and challenged by religious and ethnic divisions. His family and friends support his presidential aspirations, but they have some misgivings.
Kalau saya sendiri kurang yakin sebetulnya, kasihan gitu loh. Istilahnya belum selesai gubernur kalau langsung dicalonkan tuh saya kasihan.
But despite his concerns, his old friend Bandy is passionately campaigning for Jokowi.
Halo, siapa ini?
Jokowi. Jokowi.
Ini fans berat ya?
Ya, fans berat Jokowi.
Iya, betul. Jadi semua orang pakai ini?
Iya.
Wajah Jokowi?
Wajah Jokowi 100 orang.
100 orang?
Iya. Nah, kita akan pendukung berat.
Others are shaving their heads to show support.
Itu loh, bila Jokowi itu loh, presiden.
While his mother prays.
Lah, anak karo mau punya keinginan, punya cita-cita. Kan orang tua selalu mendoakan.
Ibu nggak pernah minta beliau, ya jangan, jangan, itu bahaya.
Oh, enggak, saya enggak. Enggak, saya enggak minta. Dia sendiri kan sudah bisa mengira-ira ini bahaya apa enggak ini. Enggak, saya enggak pernah pesan.
Mau enggak, berani enggak Jokowi mereformasi perangkat hukum? Hakim, jaksa, polisi, membersihkan militer dari orang-orang yang nggak benar, yang korup, berani nggak?
The leader also need, as a pilot, as a, need to carry, to bring people to the right direction.
And he doesn't have that.
We don't know yet. What is his vision, his mission about Indonesia? Put him in the debate. Yeah, put him in the debate. Let him talk for 1 hour about what he's going to do with Indonesia.
You think he can't do it?
He cannot do it. Because he doesn't know what to do with Indonesia.
There's no concept.
No concept. That's very dangerous for a leader.
Try telling that to his die-hard supporters. Whose faith in this former carpenter is the envy of politicians across Indonesia.
Apakah saudara-saudara siap memerahkan Indonesia? Siap! Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Bapak pernah bayangkan sebagai anak yang tinggal di pinggir kali dan juga anaknya tukang kayu bisa dicalonkan sebagai presiden, Pak?
Tidak. Tidak. Kehidupan tidak datang, Om. Kehidupan tidak ada yang tahu. Kehidupan itu misteri. Dan itu saya lalui dari masa kecil saya sampai sekarang.
Jokowi, pilihanku.
While Joko Widodo knows it won't be easy, he hopes that he will have a chance to lead the nation.
Saya kira ini baru dimulai. Perjalanan dan proses masih panjang.
Dan rumit.
Dan berat. Dia meyakinkan masyarakat bahwa kita mampu, bahwa Indonesia mampu, bahwa pemerintah mampu, bahwa rakyat mempunyai daya saing dengan negara-negara yang lain. Harus diyakinkan itu. Bekerja harus optimis. Bekerja tidak boleh pesimis.